Okay, now we're ready to make our beef stew. So what I have here, this is a nice pan that I have. This is what's called an enameled cast iron. So it's cast iron on the inside, and it's got an enamel baked on coating on the outside. So I got this hot first. And you can see the little brown pieces I just put in. I put those in first to see how hot it was, and it wasn't quite hot enough. So I took those out and let the pan heat up a little bit more. I want it hot where the oil shimmers, but not smoking hot. That's too hot. So I have the heat set about medium high because I want to get some browning in the meat. So I come back every now and then and stir. You don't have to stir constantly. I cut a lot out of this particular video, but I'll stir it and I'll let it go for 5 or 6 minutes, and then I'll come back and I'll stir it again. But really, all I want to do is get a good surface browning. I'm not looking to cook the meat all the way through. So at this point, I like how it looks. It's about as far as I want. It's got a nice brown color. And so what I'm going to do is remove it from the pot, because this pot's just not quite big enough to get everything in there and develop color like I want. So if I had put the vegetables in, they would have steamed. They wouldn't really have gotten any color. So I take the meat out, and I'm letting the pot sit. Still on the heat, I put a little bit more oil in there, and I'm letting it heat back up. So once it's hot again, then I'm going to put my vegetables in there. So you saw all the brown on the bottom, and all that brown is good stuff. That's what's called fond, F-O-N-D. And during this process of sweating the mirepoix, it's going to start to loosen up that fond a little bit. So don't worry about it right now. So this, I've turned the heat down just a little bit on this. I still want some good color on these. But I don't want them to burn, and I don't want to burn that fond on the bottom. So I'm running it about a medium, just over medium heat, and letting it cook. Then once everything has a translucent look to it, once the onions are no longer white, that's when I'll take my red wine, and I pour my red wine in here. And I have about, I don't know, a half, three quarters of a cup of red wine that I'll pour in here. And then I stir everything up, and then I let it simmer like that. That's my garlic going in. I don't let the garlic cook very long. So it's going in the last 2 minutes of cooking for the vegetables. So here's my wine. I'll add that. I'll stir it really well. And let that simmer for just a sec. The acid in the red wine helps loosen all those bits on the bottom. So I'll let this simmer a little bit, and then I'll come back to it in a few minutes. So now the heat's come back up. It's simmered a little bit. It's reduced a little bit. Most of the alcohol has already burned off of this wine. Now, this wine is a Rodney Strong wine. It's a blend, a red blend. Really, if you have a Cabernet Sauvignon or a Syrah or something like that, that'll work just fine. The only thing I wouldn't do is a Pinot, because they tend to have very light flavors and it just won't come through very well. So I've stirred it up, and if you noticed, all the fond on the bottom is gone now. It's all dissolved into the liquid. So here I'm taking some of my, adding my meat back in, and I'm adding my stock that I made last week. And I'm going to cook this. I'm going to add my tomato paste, stir that in really well. And then I'm going to get my, other seasonings. I have a bay leaf that I put in here. I have parsley stems that I put in here. I also have thyme that I'll put in here in just a second. That's my sachet, except I just tie it up with a string, and I don't even really bother to tie the string onto the handle. I just leave it on the outside so that I can pull it out when I'm ready to. So here I'm going to add my bay leaf. There it is. And then right after that, I'm going to add my other herbs. stir them in, push them down, make sure they're under the surface, and then I'll cover the pot. But just before I cover the pot and put her to sleep for an hour or so, I'm going to taste the seasonings. I tasted it, and it tasted pretty good. I was going to let it go until the closer to the end of cooking and taste it again, but it tastes good. It does need just a touch of salt, but I haven't added my potatoes yet. So I'm going to come back in an hour after it's had a chance to simmer and taste it again. And then I probably won't even adjust the seasonings fully until the very end of cooking. So now here goes the lid, and good night for the next hour when I come back to check it.